What's up, everybody? Oh, we're not in... Shoot, I forgot to put us, like, in space.
Oh, well.
Oh, well.
Now we're in blue grid land. We're trapped in the background. We're stuck
in the grid.
Here.
Getting out of the matrix. Lanny's sick. He might be in the chat. Yeah, and I'm feeling like my throat's all scratchy. It's probably just allergies, but now I'm paranoid. I don't get it.
I think I eat enough fast food that my body just, on contact, kills every bacteria that comes at me. Because I went to Anime Expo. More than likely,
yeah,
the biggest breeding ground of germs and disease
actually
this side of the Mississippi.
Mm-hmm.
And... I think I made it up fine. I could be a carrier. I might be holding a bunch.
Yeah,
of
that's what I mean. You might be a harbinger.
Just handing them out to everybody.
But like I get sick,
like,
my girlfriend gets sick. You don't.
They're like, this is a war-free zone. Like, keep it safe.
You're the ley line.
Keep this temple holy.
That's right,
my friends.
Keep the temple holy. Honor it. Honor thy father. Honor thy mother. How's your mom doing?
Well, that's an odd question. I believe she is in North Carolina visiting
for what?
My aunt.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think.
What for?
No, I'm not positive. I just think she went there just to be there. All I know is when I called her on 4th of July, she was driving there.
Oh, okay.
So she was either only going to be there for a little bit. She might be back by now. I don't know.
Okay, gotcha.
So she was on her way to.
Yeah, I called my mom yesterday.
How did that go? How is she?
She was good.
She's been. You didn't need a holiday to call yours, huh?
No, I didn't. I just called her because I wanted to. Because
wow.
I'm a good son.
Huh. Neat.
Yeah. Right. Anyways, we got stuff. We got things. Didn't have anything planned for today. I'm looking away because I have to look at this direction.
Right.
It's not like I don't care about you.
There was something I wanted to play, but apparently I didn't bring that SNES cartridge, so I'll have to replace Uniracers at some point.
Dude, Uniracers is dope.
Better than any Sonic game, says this reviewer.
I can concur with that.
And if you name your character Sonic because it's on a Nintendo platform, it blinks not cool. And I'm not making that up.
Does it really?
Yes.
That's awesome! I love when they're throwing shade. We got Carisu with the 500 for the
Woo!
Expert level pre-stream video. Great job, guys. Love you. Love you too, Carisu. Carisu trolls around my streams as well. Hope you're doing well, buddy. We're gonna kick it over to this screen.
Oh,
now we're in space.
Now we're in space.
Now it's casual.
Oh, now
it's right.
Air in space.
You can.
Oh, that's right. I swallowed my rebreather gum.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's gonna be fine.
Yeah, you swallowed your rebreather gum.
Yes. There was some sci-fi thing where they had to chew some gum and that let them breathe. I don't remember what that was, though. Chad, if you remember what I'm talking about.
Chewing gum to breathe in space?
Part of me wants to think it was a Lost in Space, but I think that might be wrong.
I could see that.
But there was some very simple, like, oh, just use this magic MacGuffin and you'll be fine in space.
Okay.
Was it a Futurama thing? I don't know. Maybe that's what it
was. People are saying
Jimmy Neutron. That might have been it.
I could see Jimmy Neutron. I think that's actually
right,
true.
A lot of people are saying Jimmy Neutron. It must have been in it.
Okay, must have been Jimmy.
That explains why I didn't remember, because that was a very forgettable movie and show.
It was, so much so that I conflate their release dates. People asking about Tuesday, because we'll kick it back here, because, you know, it's casual. Who gives a shit? Back on this one, there's nothing on Tuesday, and
nothing.
There's no thingy. We haven't decided what to do for Tuesday yet.
Yes, we're not quite sure.
So.
Still up in the air.
That's why we'll
But there will be a stream on Tuesday.
Yeah, there'll be a, there,
okay.
Tuesday's not going anywhere, so, we just don't have anything planned
there
yet.
There will be a stream.
It's not drinking, so I didn't want to put the mug.
Right, we just ain't know what it's gonna be yet.
So I got no idea. What's gonna be there? I don't know what else we had. I don't know, just casual up.
The aliens from Mars Attacks also use that to breathe on Earth. That might be what I'm thinking.
Ooh, that.
I don't think I saw the Jimmy Neutron movie, and that's what everyone's citing.
Okay, I could see that. We also had our little Real Talk episode of Attack of the Saiyans came out. I'm glad people liked that. That was a good one. I'm glad people enjoy us just bullshit.
Yeah.
That's what I like to do.
We're a casual duo.
We are pretty casual. Anyways.
It's just kind of the people we are.
I got a video game here.
So I've noticed Gundam versus.
Yes, you pronounced that correctly.
I see a G in there, so I assume it's a G Gundam game.
It is not a G Gundam game. Don't say that. Mm. You're gonna make everybody spam it in the chat. There's no G Gundam suits. Sorry.
No G Gundam suits.
That's correct. Get it out of your system.
Oh man.
They'll be in there later. They're not in there now.
All
right.
Like DLC or something.
Yes. There hasn't been a single one of these games without them, but they're not in here right now. Anyways, I've been waiting for this game for a long time.
That like you have, my friend.
I got up at 10 in the morning to play this the second it was available. I don't do that for games. At least, like, anymore.
Yeah.
I used to.
Been a hot minute since you lined up or were there for a midnight release.
Anyways, this is Gundam Versus. This is coming out to the States.
So what's its full title? Just so...
Gundam Versus.
Just Gundam Versus?
This is the premium G-Sound edition. That's why it has those extra words.
But when it becomes released in the States, it will just be
It's just Gundam Versus for the PlayStation 4 home console.
It's not Gundam Extreme Versus Full Boost Accent Core Plus.
No, it is just regular-ass Gundam Versus. This is a reboot Cataclysm of the franchise, counter. Basically, for home consoles.
Fantastic.
Enjoy the... This intro.
All right.
All right. And there's Barbie. Good old Barbatos.
So this is when the Gundams attacked New York.
Correct.
And just tore it down.
Uh-huh.
And they had their big old robot party.
Gundams are the Beastmen. They're invading the underground.
The robot block party.
Mm-hmm.
And they were like, there are too many humans on Earth. We have to force them underground. Look at that.
Looking pretty. But that's it. That's a really shitty intro.
That's actually really bad.
That's really dumb. Not a fan of the intro.
Sorry, Gundam Versus.
Not a fan of the intro. Anyways, this is Gundam Versus.
Gundam Versus. Got it.
Gundam Versus. And it's a video game. I love Extreme Versus. If you remember our Days of Yore, we did a... Nick and I did a...
Way back when.
Games were thankful for. Gundam Versus, I think it was my number 3. Because I got to meet a whole bunch of Tomodachis from playing Gundam Versus. It's going to be on Moon Runes, but don't worry, I will. I'm here to be your tour guide. So
I can guess from the little pictures on the side what some of them probably
are. Can you pronounce that word? What does that say? Can you read that one?
Like the one you're highlighting?
Uh-huh, yeah, what does that say?
That's Prey.
Mm-hmm, Prey.
Playsu.
Yeah, Mobidu Sutsu is what that says. Briefing Room Settings. Can you read that one?
Your accent on some of these just seems...
too good?
Accurate.
So we got a whole bunch of suits here of this game. It's a reboot. Extreme Versus. I have a freaking lozenge. That's why I sound like this. Let me...
Gotcha. Seeing some complaints on my volume, so I'll get closer to my microphone.
So, this game has a whole bunch of mobile suits, as they call them. They're not just Gundams, Grant.
Did
you know that?
I did actually know that.
Yeah, I know you did know that.
I'm not gonna.
What ones have you seen?
I have seen 0080.
Okay.
A solid chunk of G Gundam.
No.
That Gundam Origin thing we watched.
Yeah, that was a good one.
I watched a lot of Gutted Rin's Mobile Suit Gundam Abridged.
Of course you did.
That actually was fairly informative.
It was.
I feel like there's another one I watched, but I'm not.
If there was, I don't remember it.
I'm blanking on it.
Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and show off all the robots here. We got a whole bunch of...
So here's our Mobile Suit Gundam.
Yeah, I know, because everyone's going to whine that there's no G, but there's almost 100.
There's OGs.
There's OGs. We got see the big old G? It's G Gundam. Got regular-ass Gundam. Mm-hmm. Gun Cannon Gun Tank. Good old Zaku. From the Salt episode, by the way.
Oh, that's the Salt Zaku.
Yeah, that's the Salt Zaku who punches people. He's great. Got three forms of Char, three different flavors.
Ooh.
Whole bunch of stuff. For people that might, you know, like a Gundam, like anime, I'll just quickly go over.
That one just looks like Robot Master Chief.
Who does?
To the left? That one. Kind of just like...
It's called the Nemo.
It's
the
got
Nemo.
Kind of Master Chief's helmet face thing.
Yeah, a little. I could see that.
Can I be a Big Zam?
You cannot be a Big Zam. You cannot be a Game Grump.
Okay.
However, you can fight the Zigbam.
Okay.
We got stuff from Char's Counterattack. We got Unicorn. That's a cool one. I like Unicorn. Got a whole bunch of little grunty babies. Look at all these robots.
I think I built a unicorn. I did not watch it.
Did you build? Yeah, you did build a unicorn.
Yes.
Got stuff from F91. Got three suits from Victory. Look at all these. You got your wing representation for all of you, all you Toonami babies.
You Toonami faithfuls.
Toonami faithfuls, what they call them. We got all the, we have the main ones from season 2, because I know these are the ones people will care about. It's got Wing Zero, Death Scythe Hell, Heavy Arms Kai, Sandrock Kai, Ultron, and Epion, who is actually good in this game, unlike the last one. He was terrible, but now they gave him one thing that makes him good. Talgeese 2 and Talgeese. And you got supports that can do the other ones. Turn a Gundam. Whole bunch of good stuff.
You can turn your Gundam. You
can turn it upside down. Give it a mustache.
Turn a Gundam.
Turn a Gundam on its head. We got Seed. No Seed Destiny, thank God. It'll probably be in later, just like G. Double O's.
Double O's, that's...
We know that one.
Not a series I watched all the way through, but I watched at least one episode multiple times.
We watched one episode. We got Reconquista, Reconquista in G. Got that stuff there. Look at these. Look at those robots.
These look more like modern designs.
Because
like,
they are.
When did this anime happen?
Reconquista, I think, was 2014. I could be wrong. Okay. Could be earlier.
I'm not digging some of these. That one seems okay.
Yeah, he's okay, but like...
That one? No, thank you.
Yeah, Mac Knife does not look typical gun to me. This is the newest series, Iron-Blooded Orphans. It's pretty divisive. Some people like it, some people hate it. Right. That's the regular ass one.
I feel
it looks
like the first two episodes didn't catch me, but I
same.
Also don't know if it gets better with time.
Eighth MS Team. People like that one. Got the Easy Eight, got the Ground Gundam, and the Goof Custom. All great. Thunderbolt, my boys. Not meant for ground combat, so they look ridiculous.
Okay.
that's
all right.
They got so much stuff. They're rad. Psycho Zaku is my current main and full armor Gundam. From Missing Link, a PS3 game that like maybe 12 people played.
Where's, which one's the Geass?
Oh, the Geass?
Yes.
The Geass. It's this one here, because that was a pretty random
Ooh,
reference.
Okay, thank you.
That's a good one.
It's up there with the Megazord and Big O.
Oh, Megazord, Big O. Where's the Zoids? Where's the Transformers?
Zoids, thank you.
That's
a
good one. Good
where's
joke.
Where's Optimus in all
Oh,
this?
Yeah, where's Optimus fit in? Stuff from Crossbone. Stuff we got this one. Then Hot Scramble Gundam, who's top tier garbage. He's so good. He's the 30th anniversary, like, celebration suit thing. But yeah, we got a whole bunch of stuff.
Neat.
And I just wanted to show that off. And we'll go ahead and do...
So how do you play this video game? Is it like a Mortal Kombat where we're looking at each other and we
It is not a Mortal Kombat where we're looking at each other.
Will I be playing with you?
You will not be playing with me because it's only one person.
Okay.
However, this game is made to be played 2-on-2. It's a 2-on-2 competitive arena fighter.
But no couch co-op.
No couch co-op.
All right.
Unlike the previous edition, this one does not have couch co-op. I can go ahead and show off a bit of it. Let's demo Epion. Actually, no, Epion's not a good suit to demo.
Fortunately, I'm really bad at this game, so... It's okay that there's no couch co-op for this
But
evening.
I want to play it with you.
No, I understand. When it comes out here in the West,
I want to play with you.
And you're already really good, and so are all your friends, I can be the guy that you power level.
That's right. I think I got... Yeah, I got him. So we'll show off Wing Zero, because people like that one.
Sure.
And we'll have... Let's see.
Who's our best friend going to be?
Our best friend... Let's have the Goof Custom. Why not?
All right.
He looks cool.
Pull to the Goof Troop.
That's a good one, Grant. And we'll go to... Let's fight just rando.
Yeah.
What we got? Surprise me. A randomized 500 and
a randomized
300.
This has the same point system, right? Where you have, like... Your team's health is basically a culmination of points, and if the goof dies, it'll take 300 from your bar, but if you die, it'll take 500 from the bar.
Exactly.
Because you are a slightly better machine.
Yeah, okay. I have... They're all kind of balanced. Yeah, they're balanced out. Like, you have 1,000 points in total. Let's do random stage. We'll do...
So basically, you can die twice. Well, actually, you could die up to 3 times.
I can die twice.
Your AI buddy could die up to 3 times, so long as you never die.
Yeah.
So you want to hold on to your life as long as you can, because you dying takes more points from the total.
And I'll go ahead and show off. Oh, we're fighting turn A and duel. There we go. Let's show off this game. This fidget game.
It's a video game. Because, yeah, for a bit it took me a while to understand what the, like, health and point system is for your team.
Yeah, this game has a whole bunch of stuff.
And it's still Red reticle means you can't hit him.
Red reticle means you can.
Oh, you can. Okay.
Yeah.
Yellow is out of
Yellow
range.
Is you can't.
Okay.
And this game's real anime.
I can tell just by the music.
I got the premium G Sound Edition, which comes with a lot of the extra anime themes.
See, that's the version they get me on. I'm not even a Gundam fan, but I'd be like, more background music? Yes, please.
Yep. It was like an extra, I don't know, like $20 for like 40 more songs. But sure.
Like, no, that's a deal in my mind.
Yeah, and they're all like theme songs. They're not like garbage. Yeah, they're all themes from shows and stuff, which is cool. That said, the one coming out in the West will not have, it's just going to be the regular ass
version.
Yeah, so that's a little lame. Let me do, let me get this blast off. Call my assist.
Okay, so
I'll explain it more. I'm just showing it off.
Yeah. I'll let you do your thing for a bit.
See if I can win with the burst here.
While I color commentate.
Shit!
He says right before falling.
All right, they're launching a nuke. That's good.
All right, cool. Good.
Fall into your nuke.
Nice.
Okay, good. And hey, here we win.
Boom! Got him. Took their point meter down. Perfect.
Look at that. Anime. So if you've seen Gundam Wing, that should sound familiar. The American version, I know people will be asking, comes out September 29th. So that's when that happens.
Also, September 29th, it's practically just a slightly late birthday party for you.
Exactly. I also got a few bitteronis here from Rise Up. 500%. Hope you guys enjoy the fun with the real Gundams in space. Also, thoughts on the Insane trilogy?
I played a little bit of it today. Messed with it. Seems really good.
I really like it. I like it a lot. It's really good. But I'll go ahead and explain a bit more of how the game works. So if you look through all the stuff here, like, for example, Wing Zero costs, you can look at the bottom left. You see it says 500 and he's various. That means you can fill basically any role. It's a 2-on-2 game, so there are roles you want to keep in mind. You don't want, like, two melee dudes.
A team, like a range man and a melee man.
I'll speak
various
in...
Various means you can do kind of both.
Exactly. If you're fighting, like, Death Scythe, your goal is to go
you're
in and
front.
hit people with your scythe,
which
obviously
is the kind of game I like to play. So
yeah.
I'll probably be looking at the guys with the fighting tag.
Yeah, so you'll be looking for these melee dudes who are all really, really good at melee stuff. And, like, Epion, for example, has no guns. He is only sword.
Just put his hands on him.
And then, for example, Heavy Arms, however, doesn't even have a sword. His melee is shooting missiles, so his goal is to stay far away, pepper him with shots. A little tough to use. However, Various F is, like, you know, various, but better at fighting, for example. So it kind of tells you what build you can expect from these characters. It's a four-button fighter, kind of like six, but just like ABC is, like, shoot, melee, and jump. And you have an assist button, which calls out a dude, and now there's... like, I think 250 or more to see assists.
To be a Gundam Master.
And you unlock them through leveling up a bunch of stuff. It's really awesome. I really, really like it. But I can go ahead and talk a bit about more how it works while we do another fight. Hey, there's Sandrock over there.
Check out that Sandrock.
So, when you're in green lock like this, they're too far away. When they're in red, your shots will home in on them. Hit the A button, you shoot. You got your ammo counters on the right, so my main button's going down. Hit B. You do a slash.
You do, like, a melee attack.
Do some melee. There we go. Do some melee shit. Hit A and B together. Do your sub-weapon. His is like a little chest cannon.
Okay.
That's your second ammo bar you can see there. Your third one, hit A and C. C is how you jump. That's how I'm doing all this, like, boost stuff. You can also hold boost and then double tap, and I'm a bird.
Okay, I'm into that. I like that.
There's a lot of transforming suits, and they are really, really strong if you can transform. Look at that. I'm out of here.
Yeah. Come get me!
And if you hit A and C together, you do your special shot, which is this. I missed, but... hey, there you go.
I get the idea.
You can see a little thing that says charge in English at the bottom. Right now it says max. I got the zero system. That's his special melee. And right now the zero system is a special thing to Gundam Wing where shots won't lock onto you.
Okay.
So it's really good. You can just get in, go bonkers.
Important question from the chat.
Yes.
What Gundam do you think Dumplin would pilot? What's the biggest Gundam?
Oh, that's what I was thinking. Probably the Virtue, and the Virtue's not out yet. Virtue's the fat Gundam.
All right.
Like, just actually large.
Just rounded.
Yeah. But Virtue will be in, like, I think in 2 days, Virtue comes out. Oh, my God. Toward my face.
The thing is, Dumpling is also the demon god. I can see him being a bit of an edgelord and
going
for that death sight.
I can see him playing death sight. He likes going up and using one combo over and over. I can see him probably playing Epion.
Yeah, death sight probably has a fuck box.
Yeah, death sight has a fuck box. Things you gotta consider. But there's a whole bunch of this game. It's a competitive, balanced game. So everything I'm doing, while it may look really frantic,
has a purpose.
Yeah, everything has a purpose. There's a reason I'm like turning when I do this, and then I drop down. Because you have a boost gauge at the bottom. That's how much you can fly around.
And there's a lot of like cancels and stuff. Like
everything is pretty much cancelable.
Yeah, you cancel stuff with dashes, right?
Yeah, so I can like shoot. Instead of having to sit here and go like smash shoot.
Yeah.
I can do like that and die. Your goal is to keep moving. Go nuts.
That guy got you.
Well, he's a dumb guy.
Did he just blow himself up? Or no, that was you.
No, yeah, I blew myself up.
Okay.
Because that's what
I thought his victory pose was exploding.
Well, it kind of is. If you've seen Wing, their victory pose is exploding.
Ah.
We can show off something from people like 8th MS team.
Sure.
We can show off some long-range stuff.
Throw me through as someone who... Okay,
oh,
so
God,
I know...
What?
I know Universal Century...
Sure.
I know that is different than, like, the non-canon Gundams or something.
Yeah.
So kind of tell me, like, place me in the timeline. What's the atmosphere? What's the war between Earth and Spacenoids?
I mean, which... For 8th MS team?
Yeah. For each suit we go to, tell me, like,
give you a little story.
Yeah, give me, like, a quick biopic. Like, I know Wing is not canon. It's not part of the Universal Century.
Yeah, Universal Century is its own beast. Everything else is, like, alternate universe.
Okay. And so Wing does not fit into that timeline.
No, Wing is its own self-contained thing. Every series that is not Universal Century is its own thing.
Understood.
G is its own thing.
Yes.
Wing is its own thing. X is its own thing. Iron-Blooded Orphans, it's own thing. They're all their own thing
really?
If they're not UC, yes.
Yeah, and I know Zeon are like Nazis, but some series they're the good guys.
They're like debatably the good or bad guys, depending on how you look at it.
Well, it's like one of those things, and I think that's one thing I really like about the idea of the Gundam series, is that there is no like, this team is always the bad guys.
Yeah.
It is bad people come into power. On both sides.
Yes.
And drive these sides to do bad things. Which I really like that. It is, you know, accurate to what history is like.
Yeah, I really like it. Oh, hang on, this... trying to load a thingy there. I saw some bitteronis, but my thingy isn't working. So here's... From 8th MS team.
So 8th MS team, what was going on with this one?
This is during the 1 year war. These are basically, you know, while stuff's happening in space. And like, Amuro's off doing his thing. This is what the people are doing on Earth.
Okay.
So they have, like, ground Gundams, which are, like, you know, they took the Gundam designs.
So these guys are contemporaries with
Amuro. These are the grunts. Like, this is... That's why people like 8th MS Team. It's a very down-to-earth military story.
Because they're on Earth.
Yeah, because they're... Shut up. And so, as you'll see, they actually run around. You know, they don't fly.
Oh.
They run.
Really cool, actually.
So you see, like, they run like this. You can fly. Like, you can boost. Like, you can still boost. But their main thing is running. And this is, like, run canceling is their thing. And, like, it's a thing they can do. To be able to like hop around and stuff, like their air mobility is awful, but on the ground they are amazing.
And for those who are the uninitiated, so the big like conflict in Gundam is between the people who live on Earth and the people who basically moved to space.
Yeah, basically people started living in space colonies, and then people in one space colony said, "Why do we gotta listen to Earth rules? We're in space, bitch!" So they took one colony and dropped it on Earth, and declared war.
Gotcha.
And then everyone was like, well, fuck it, we're from Earth, we should be on Earth. And the other way, I was like, fuck you, I was born in space, I don't care about Earth.
Zeon are space people, Earth.
Federation are Earth people.
Federation are Earth people.
Yep. Come here, Wing Zero. You garbage.
Kill that wing suit.
I'll do it. Kill him with my grunt baby. Look at this. Easy 8 in a ball, gonna kick your ass, Wing Gundam. Get out of here. Come down, say hi.
Boom.
Oh, hi, Banshee. I'm gonna kill that guy. He's got too much going on for him. Oh shit, my partner's about to die, and that's what happens sometimes. It's a team game. I died a bunch.
Yeah.
They died once.
And like, so the thing with this franchise, it has spanned what, 25, 30 years? Quite a
Gundam's at 30, I believe. Maybe even more. No, more.
More?
I think it's more than that.
70s?
It was 70s.
Oh. But
35 maybe? Can't remember.
But it's existed for quite a while.
The
story I always heard was Mobile Suit Gundam aired, but it aired in the afternoon and was like, you know, all these robots and war and stuff was initially going to be like a show for boys.
Yep.
But moms fell in love with the drama and the, like, the political intrigue.
Uh-huh.
So they like really veered into that.
And then they started selling model kits and everyone was like, oh shoot.
Yeah.
We got a gold mine.
Which I think is amazing.
Yeah. Like, it was basically Star Trek.
Yeah.
In Japan. It's the same thing. Let's do another cool
Seen lots of 79. Apparently that's the...
Yeah, 79.
Apparently that's the year it started.
Because 0079. Duh. Don't you know?
Oh.
Says the expert. I gotta put on, of course, our Gundam songs.
Yes. Do we have Gundam-o?
You want Gundam-o?
Yes.
Okay, if you want Gundam-o, I can Gundam-o.
One of my favorite Gundam tracks.
It's a great track.
It's a track with like five fake endings before it gets to the real one.
Okay, hey, now the bitteronis are working. Sorry, fam. They were working for a sec. Citizen Lawyer, are you guys going to check out the new Castlevania series? Got a Berserk Bloodborne vibe.
Ooh. I know nothing about it. I haven't seen a single preview image of it. I only heard that it exists. I'm sure I'll look into it at some point.
Well, Wing Zero again. I'm sure I'll check it out.
Yeah, now here's Gundam music.
Come here. Oh god!
Don't know the Japanese, so I can't sing along until they hit the
music. Go, Zaka buddy! So, Doan throws rocks.
All right,
that's what he
I like
does.
That. That's pretty good.
He throws rocks. I'll see if I can get it off.
Gundam.
He goes nuts.
Gundam.
And a one punch. Oh,
that's pretty fucking cool.
That is fucking super. He's amazing. Oh, come here, boy.
Maybe he will be my main.
Yeah, you just go in, you punch, you go nuts. And if you pick him, the guy I'm currently maining has a really good team comp with him. Okay, he's got like a sidestep. All right.
I saw a couple people asking which Gundam to, like, which one should they watch? I'm guessing as beginners or just
the first three movies, like the UC movies, I think are a good way to start. Or if you want something like instantly good, 0080.
I was gonna say, 0080 was the first thing I watched, and I thought it was incredible. And this was me knowing next to nothing about Gundam. It's just a very good war story. And it's like what, like five episodes long? Like,
yeah, I think six.
It's like nothing.
See if I can kill Zero with a one punch. Come here, buddy.
Get up there. Fist that gun wing.
Get out! Bitch!
That's real cool. I am into that.
Yeah. Bam! So this is the Zaku that doesn't use no weapons. He throws rocks and punches.
Oh, that's dumb and I.
Yeah, he's
really
great.
Like that.
Show off some more. I'll do some like story modes and eventually do like some online fights to show off how this actually works. But for now, I'll just do some exhibition garbage.
Yeah, have fun and tell me about what Gundam you're using, what they did, what their contribution was.
So right now I'm using Epion. This is where Zex has reaffirmed his identity as Miliardo Peacecraft.
Ooh, okay.
And says
and he was the dude with the mask and
he was
wing,
the dude with
right?
the mask okay. and wing, and he took it off and says, "I'm not Char. I'm Miliardo Peacecraft."
But he's not in the same universe as Char, right?
No, but they're all every Gundam show has a Char analog.
Okay,
it's like a thing.
Gotcha.
It's kind of like a meme.
A masked villain.
Like there he is again. He is actually a Char clone. I mean, spoilers, but there you go.
Okay.
Every series is like a char dude. Like even Ternay has got their char
an
dude.
As Nable.
Yeah, an ass nipple. Let's have him on there. Let's double down on our chars. Our chars.
That dude looks like the hunter chick from the Diamond and Pearl series of Pokemon. Maybe it was Black and White. There was some series where there was a chick with a Salamence, and she was real cool, and she had these orange shades.
Okay. I believe you. Let's put on another wing track.
Silver hair.
They have so many freaking wing songs. Let's see for the motion. The other opening.
Yes, Pokemon Hunter J. I knew I wasn't just making that up. I think she's a Pokemon villain who you actually might see die.
Oh, really?
I feel like in her last show up, she's in a caught in an explosion.
So here we go. This is Epion got really good in this game because he has the zero system, which, if you remember, makes people can't target you. So we give ourselves a super sword, and Epion has a really easy combo. It's called...
Okay, that's fun.
if you can't hear it, here's how you play Epion, guys. Okay, here we go. I'm going to play Epion.
I want you to do this online so people who lose to you can go back and look at you showing off.
That's how you play Epion.
Whoa.
You just mash A and B as fast as possible. Because his, you know how you can, like, cancel moves? So his melee is a sword and his shoot is a sword, so they cancel into each other.
So just back and forth.
So you can play it like a little baby. Just go like, hey, Dad. How do I play Gundam?
Oh, that looks great. That's pretty fun. Perfect.
Say, there's Epion.
Gave me an Epi hard on with that one. Thanks.
The Hooded Teddy with 500 says, "Can your hand glow with an awesome power?" Not yet. Neos Arcadia with 1500. "Hey, Kieran, is Shining Gundam in the game or will it be coming to the game? That will be my deciding factor on buy or no." It won't be on the launch, but I don't know if there's going to be DLC coming out before like the West release comes out. I don't know if we're just going to...
might be out by the time...
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to launch like in America with just the base roster.
I have this crazy feeling the Western release will still have Japanese voices.
Oh, absolutely.
Probably not be getting our beloved dub.
We will not be getting our beloved dub, unfortunately.
No, because of this guy!
He was a spoiled brat. So yeah, Epion would... I just can see Dumplin' playing Epion.
Alright, yeah, I can see that.
It's very, very easy. Oh, somebody mentioned GP03. I want to show off GP03. GP03 is dumb. This is in Stardust Memory. This is 83. A few years after the one-year war.
Yes.
There's a few people who are like, nah, man, Zeon for life. Zeon forever. I don't care if we lost. We still won in my heart.
Lost the war, but they're still holding to the values.
Yep. Rocking that Confederate space flag.
Yep. They seceded from the Earth Nation.
it's true.
Yeah.
And Blitz. I give Siege shit, but Blitz is an awesome design.
Yeah.
Don't you love it? So GP03 was one of the first. I'll go ahead and talk a bit about nerdy model kits. GP03 was one of the first model kits I made. You know how like their 1/144 scale?
Yeah.
Right? GP03's 1/144 scale model, however, is different.
Okay.
Because the GP03 itself is about an inch tall. Because it's busy being inside of another robot. That is massive. And when I get my ultimate, we'll summon that thing.
Sure. So wait, so is this not currently size accurate? Should you be
No, I'm correct size.
Okay.
But compared to everything else,
my
final form, if you will.
Compared to your final form?
Yeah. It's just baby mode.
So is this currently planned only a PS4 release? No.
Yep,
PC,
PS4, that's it. Nope.
X-Bone.
No bone, no PC.
No bone
as far as is planned. But you can see we're summoning like little bits and pieces of something bigger. I just need enough meter to get it. Also, all the music is amazing.
Yeah, I'm digging this too.
I didn't pick the winner, which I need to. And come here. Come here, bubby. Are we going to see it? We might see it, hopefully. Oh, did I kill him with it? Oh, I killed him with the actual hit. We didn't see it. He summons a big old thing for his finisher. There's his... That's the handgun of the thing. Look, he doesn't even get it.
Get it all in frame.
Yeah. He's, Let me change the background music real quick. There it is. This is my jam.
You're a winner.
Team Malaysia, we'll get to smooth jazz. Don't worry. Grant heard jazz earlier.
Yeah, I heard free jazz earlier. It was a track. Let's just say maybe not every track in the game is fire.
Yeah, maybe not everyone. I missed you. Shit.
People asking how is this one not the one jumping with Pilot?
This one?
I guess the big gun, maybe?
Oh. Maybe. I just feel like he's a bit more of a cheeser. He got along with Epion pretty well.
This is an honest Gundam.
This is an honest suit.
It's one of my favorite fighting game terms.
Nothing goofy.
I play an honest character. What does that even mean?
Oh, here comes the chorus, though. In a sec. I goofed.
I don't think there are any goofs on your team.
There is not a goof on my team. I should fix that. One health! The dream! Let's do it.
Oh, he's doing
it! Yes! Oh! Get it! Boom! Bitch!
Oh, that's terrific.
I'm about to get the chorus, here we go! And all he does is just summon a bajillion missiles and shit.
Shoot him down.
That's what I'm doing! Oh god. I should probably set the AI to higher. Or maybe not, because he died.
Well, but if the AI is higher, maybe your AI buddy would also be better. And therefore not die.
True. Liren would pilot heavy arms? True. Plenty of guns.
Smash Flash 20, Kieran and Grant, which Gundam would you pilot?
Oh, what would I pilot?
Yeah, which mobile suit would you do, personally?
This one. This one's my favorite. I like the Turn A Gundam. Would you pick the Alex?
See, or like the Master? Alex.
But the Master you'd have to like actually punch.
Yeah, that'd be hard. I'm not sure what I would pick. I mean, knowing me, I'd just be some Grunt Zaku guy.
Probably. I could just see you piloting a Zaku. And I gotta put on Century Color. Because you had to pay extra dollars to get the Turn A themes.
Ooh.
That's how they get you.
Okay, so this is a Turn A Gundam that you're being? Or who are you being?
Turn A Gundam.
Okay.
Because Turn A Gundam is actually the best.
Is Anime Genai on here?
Anime Genai is on here, yes.
Good. Correct me if I'm wrong. Rough translation, this is not anime.
Correct.
That's so good.
Yeah. Double Zeta is amazing. Double Zeta fixed everything Zeta fucked up. Got a little too serious for me. Did you know that the Turn A Gundam was designed by Blade Runner designer Sid Mead?
Woo! I did not.
As were many of the suits. in Turn A Gundam. That's why it looks so different, and I think it's really cool. It was also meant to be, like, the super far future, because everything is canon to Turn A. Like, Zaku's show up. Oh, and I'll have to show that off, too. I'll show that when I get to the assist, so I can unlock some. Oh, but Turn A has got a surprise. A surprise in the nip.
Okay.
We got a booming rack here.
I see.
Yeah, I got them both. Oh no!
Played.
And also, it shoots nanomachines that dissolve things at an atomic level outside of its back, called Moonlight Butterfly, and it's the strongest attack in all of Gundam.
All right.
Oh geez, my partner died twice. If I die, it's over.
Thanks, partner.
Thanks, partner. Get good. Can't wait for it to come out in the West and everyone to blame their partners.
Yep. I'm already ready.
Oh, there we go. Thanks, partner. Scrub. You can set commands after you're done with a match, like thanks or I'm sorry and stuff. I can't wait to see what people set.
GG Scrub.
GG Scrub. Get good.
Thanks, co-op.
Number Hunter 64 with 1,000. Please take some of my Dokkan Battle money. You guys deserve it so much more than Bamco does. Oh, thank you. That said, support Bamco and get this game. And let's go ahead and look at, I think that's enough demoing. Let's go ahead and look at how this stuff works.
Some real stuff.
Yeah, let's get real.
All right.
So there's...
Getting real.
Remember how I said there were like 100 suits? There's... Yeah. Even more assists.
Good golly.
Yeah. There's a lot of assists, and you can use any assist with any character.
Okay.
So we're like Marvel 2 level of assists here. A lot of stuff, and you unlock them by going into, playing as a suit. You can level up every suit to 20, like Injustice, basically.
Okay.
And you unlock different strikers, they call them. So you can unlock these assists once you get him to level 3. Level 5, you can get like a little thing, you get an emblem, and you get like different titles for just, hey, I got this guy to level 20. Some of them you also can unlock waifus.
All right.
If you level up certain suits to certain levels, you can get, you can unlock waifus. They call it the Navigator. Okay. Default one is Haro.
Yeah, so right now. Nice.
Typical. You get Frau. No. Typical. You get my boy.
I was going to say.
Giren Zabi. You have to get the Gyan to level 15 to unlock him. You get Katajina. I don't know this girl's name, but hey, you know what? That's pretty anime.
That's pretty kawaii.
Nana Trinity. It's pretty anime. You can have her. Soma Pirisu. Yeah, whatever. Or
sounds too serious.
Christina. Ooh. Or Gundam knows its fan base.
But I want Bright.
You
can
get Bright. Get old man Bright.
Can he slap me?
If only DLC, you can get a Bright slap if you do bad. This comes up. We got,
I was hoping one of our 00s guys would be here.
No, none of our... No, you can play as...
yeah, I know you can play as...
You can play as Liam.
Liam.
But there's 3 00 waifus. I mean, all these girls are from 00. But yeah, I'm trying to get Giren. I'll get Giren. But what I wanted to show in, like, this just cool little Gundam lore... So everything is canon in Turn A. Like, every timeline, there's the Gundam timeline. You see everything else. Turn A.
So it just goes through all...
Everything funnels into Turn A.
That's really weird. Okay.
So everything is canon for Turn A. So Turn A is like kind of the end. And that's why it's really good.
Okay.
So in Turn A, they discover a lot of things from the Gundam universe. Like the Dark Army suits from G Gundam, they find. Zakus, they find. But they don't know they're called Zakus. They call them the Vorganons. And you can unlock a Vorganon. So
that's
it's a Zaku,
amazing.
But they call it the Vorganon.
Oh, God.
So, like, I love how much this plays with, like, Gundam lore and shit.
That's terrific.
It's so cool.
Turn A seems like a great like love letter to Gundam fans.
Turn A is the best.
And
even if you're not a Gundam fan, Turn A is really good. Let's do, go ahead and do the single player thing here. We can show off this. We can do some boss rush. Should I do easy, normal, or hard? I'm thinking like maybe let's do easy. Pick a suit.
People are saying, and turn, Jakato says, and turn X learns Shining Finger.
Yes, turn X learns Shining Finger. He says Shining Finger when he does it.
Nice.
All right. Who do I pick, chat?
Well, we
type in a suit. Because I got to refresh this source over here. You know what? Bits guarantee it.
I thought we wanted to get Gearin.
Yeah, but this isn't my real file. I don't care. Tell me what they're saying.
I've seen the name Barbados pop up a lot.
Everyone wants Barbatos?
Yes.
Good old Barbie. And where is...
Seen a little bit of Death Scythe, some Epion, Freedom.
I ain't playing Freedom. That's a good joke. There we go. Fix that.
But I feel like since the stream has started, I've seen a lot of Barbados.
Seen a lot of Barbies?
Yeah.
People want Barbies?
People are wanting Barbies.
I'm a Barbie girl.
In a Barbie world.
In a Barbie world.
Okay, that thing looks pretty cool.
Its design's awesome. Let's have Psycho Zaku support.
He's a crazy Zaku.
And for my Patona. Who else were people saying?
Saw Epion, saw Death Scythe, saw Heavy Arms.
Let's put Heavy Arms as our sidekick.
Barbados Slim, what's he gonna do?
Is that your DJ name?
No, he's a great, he's a limbo champ in the year 3000.
Mm. Alright, so I haven't seen much of Iron Blooded Orphans. Didn't care for what I saw, but this suit is awesome. He's got a gun lance thing. Just
all right.
Chuck it. As you see in the top, this is a new mode they added. You can play this online with friends. Up to 6 players can do like this little gauntlet mode, and it gets harder and harder and harder.
Okay.
You unlock a whole bunch of shit with this, and it's
so
always
I'm getting the
random
vibe
waves.
This is gonna have a lot of good online stuff.
This is made for online play.
Okay.
And the netcode is really good. Nope, miss. Yeah, you did it, Barbie. Cool tanks. Out of here.
It's funny, but I also feel bad just like some quit chat comedy.
Uh-huh.
Taka will come in and say something, and there will be so many people responding, "Hi, Taka," that I can't read what he says because it is just pushed off the screen almost immediately.
Hey, there we go. Rail Cannon. I don't know what this move does. It's like a flip. I don't know if I can, do anything out of it.
There. I see that. Hi, Taka.
So in this mode, you get random suits coming out. Like right now, we're just putzing around with these dudes.
So it's kind of just a
horde mode, basically.
Yeah, wave-based horde mode.
And you get you'll get points, you'll get battle points depending on how you did. And here comes every five waves is a boss wave. It's themed
it's
after
the
a show.
Gundam.
It's the Grundum. The Federation's white mobile suit.
Don't turn around, Amuro. I'm guessing their themes kick in anytime
yep.
they show up.
Every time they show up, you get one of their themes.
Right, that's good. Good stuff.
How do I do the... Oh, that was fancy. Hang on, let me do that again. That was nice. I have to mess with his melee, see what he does. Nice!
That's pretty
you can
cool.
just keep dunking him.
Take a
come
seat.
Come here.
Take a seat.
Okay, thanks, Heavy Arms. So you get you'll get battle points.
Okay.
And you can spend them to up your stats.
Ooh, all stuff. Right.
So as it like keeps going, you can get and these don't like carry over. These are like, you know, just for this kind of round thing. We're just gonna go ahead and up our melee damage. Make it the best.
Gundamo.
Probate with 1,000 bits. This game is only B tier until it gets G Gundam DLC. Don't be like that.
I mean, I'm on your side. I really, really want that G Gundam stuff. That's kind of those are the suits that'll really pull me in. But this does look fun.
They're all functions anyway.
Yeah.
People like playing
Master Gundam. Play Epion.
Yeah, play Epion. People like playing Master Gundam because he's got a towel. No other suit has that, but whatever. Their legacy will be preserved.
There's that one Crossbone, I think, Gundam that has like the cape.
It's Crossbone's kinda, got the cape, that's
kinda,
right.
Kind of like a towel.
It's like a towel. It's true. Yeah, this game is amazing with friends because it's a 2-on-2 competitive game. It's meant to be played 2 versus 2, so it's like, work when together, go do this, go do that.
Well, I can see this mode being super fun, too.
Yeah, like doing... Like this is the mode they're, like, heavily advertising to. And he looks cool. He looks neat. Oh, hey, Death Scythe.
You're no boss.
Oh, I got, like, maces.
Get out of there.
Oh, there's Sandrock. Ooh, what was that? Try that again.
Unlock from you.
And, like, every, Ooh! Through the building! Yeah. Instructable environments. Destructible environments.
Constructibles.
Constructibles. Lunchables. And you can't play as, like, the grunt suits, but you'll see a lot of the grunt suits in this mode, like the Leo from Wing people might recognize.
Someone in the chat asking, Kieran, do any of these mobile suits in the game have funnels?
Oh, yeah. Funnels are... tried and true part of the Gundam formula.
Super Megatron 15 saying, you know, I think the Dynasty Warrior Gundam games are actually fun.
They're great. Dynasty Warriors Gundam Reborn is really fun.
I feel like we missed one of them.
Yeah, we played Reborn. That one's great. That's the one you can play as the big Zom and just kick people. Oh, here's the 8th MS team. All of them. That's pretty cool. Even the little tank. Get out of here. You see them all running around because they suck at flying, so they'll just
no!
run.
Stay
oh
the
my
ground.
God!
Stay on the ground!
It's Bobby! Boom! And there's different melee attacks, like, you know, holding forward, down, left, right, neutral. Best melee.
I'm loving all these tracks that I recognize, despite not being a big Gundam fan, but just being friends with a lot of Gundam fans.
Yep. Now we're getting the first Gundam Seed opening, and that song rocks. Team Revolution's a good human. Yeah, so this is a really fun mode. Just a good way to test out stuff, too.
Don't Feed the Chocobo asks, is Victory in there?
Yep. V2 is in. V2, Gun Easy, and the Godder are in. That makes sense to people that know Victory. And again, this is coming out in America.
September 29th.
Ninth. Oh, gee.
Breaker 7, hey Kieran, what's the good, the bad, and the ugly about Gundam Seed?
The good? The music. The bad is the character designs. Mecha designs, too. The ugly is the character designs. The bad is redoing UC, but shittier.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd say the ugly is really the character designs. They all have same face hard. And honestly, like, right after Turn A Gundam, it was like, we're gonna go to digital! And it's, like, really bad. But the suits look really cool. I like Strike.
Great.
Great.
An extra wave finished.
I did it.
I just really like how this looks. Like this.
Oh,
looks
I know.
Super good.
Yeah, that's why. Like, it sucks that you can't do local, but if that's what has to be
done to make it look
to make
great.
It look this good, I'm fine. Because this does look amazing. That's why they had to redo the. They've been running on the same engine for a long time. So they redid this for home consoles. They're gonna. This is like their next kind of platform they're gonna start supporting. They have their arcade build, and this is gonna be like the home build. So that's why I say G's not in it right now, because they had to redo the engine and everything, and they are so hard to balance. Because this game is doesn't goof around. Everything is generally pretty balanced. Gotta kill him with two hits.
Keep boosting that melee damage.
All right. Get out of here, dude. I want to kill him in my big combo, though. I think there's like a crazy long... Oh, that's the crazy long combo. I need someone I can do it on.
Someone with health.
Yeah. Because Barbatos has a really cool combo that involves a sword. Like an actual sword. Ooh, can I do it on you, Char? There it is!
I just wanted to live!
I love how they explode to tiny bits! Who's the boss?
More waves.
Ooh! Add Zam.
And now you fight the UFO!
Alright, let's see. Just gotta get in, do like two melee combos. Jesus, that does so much damage!
Like, I'm not. No, this isn't how I fight. Stay away.
Alright. Oh, jeez.
Oh! You're not the only one with lightning gear.
Melee Super Go! Oh! Yeah! Cut him in half. Perfect.
So when it says perfect, does that mean, like, no
one I did not die.
Died?
Okay. Yeah, no, nobody died.
Because I was like, I saw you get hit.
Not getting hit is really rare.
I had a feeling.
So that's that mode. They also got like typical arcade mode. And you get a little GP that you can spend on unlocking stuff. Like that leveled us up,
Gundam
so now we
points.
Can Yeah, our Gundam points, so we can go to good old Barbie. So hey, now we unlocked his assist. So now we can call him out. And we get a title. We can say whatever that says.
So much for translating.
I know katakana. Typical arcade mode. You can go through like different stages. You can do these also online, I believe. Maybe not. I could be wrong, but I think you can.
I'm guessing branching paths for...
Yep.
What do you want to fight?
Different stuff. All right, time to go online. Let's pick Epion and make our partner feel bad.
Yeah.
If you get me as a partner... Sorry.
Icefire2050 asks, do you guys have the Hot Scramble DLC?
Yes.
I don't know what that means, but okay, yes we do.
We do.
Alright, time to play like an actual Epion player. Set it up. Stack it.
Look at that, we already got a match. That's the other cool thing, is you can practice while waiting.
Always good. Love when games have that.
Alrighty, let's do it. I'm ready to gun. Yorosuku onegaishimasu, let's go!
Playing people in actual Nippon.
No, come here! Come here! I'm gonna fight you!
Guy's like, oh god, another Epion.
Another fucking Epion player. That's what everybody says. Nakamura, I swear! Stop shooting me!
I'm the Epion!
I'm Epion!
Let me get close!
Let me hit you!
Let me Epion you!
I'm Epion!
Blaze! Just like a real Epion player.
Come here! Want Psycho Gundamite scared of your shit?
Seeing someone say the answer to Epion is nukes. Give me my GPO2.
Big sword! Okay.
It looks like you got dunked.
Wrong. I am in fact the best.
Oh!
That's how you play Gundam Versus.
Exciting.
Pick Epion and just mash buttons. 500 bits from Citizen Lawyer.
Thanks, Crossbow.
I love these Kieran Grant streams. Thank you. We love them too. Second, has DFS ever considered bringing on an in-house lawyer legal consultant? We have at one point. I don't know.
I know it's been mentioned.
It's been mentioned. We haven't made anything.
I don't know how much actual footwork has been made towards going towards that, but...
Rectangular with 5 hundo. This lunch of mine is burning red. Its loud sizzle tells me to grab an antacid. Here I go, erupting, burning chicken fingers. And now,
I like it.
Meal end. Thank you. Someone want GPO2? Let's do GPO2.
Yeah, buddy.
You know this one, right?
Yeah. I watched 0080 and a little bit of 0083.
Okay.
See, like the first, like, 4 episodes, maybe.
Gato! Alright, how do I make my sword get longer? Oh, there it is. Okay, sword get longer. Nice.
It's like the big old shield he's got.
I love GPO2. He looks so rad. Karisu-sama with the Prime resub. Hi, TFS. I watch you guys every day, and you're amazing. Nice meeting you at AX, Grant.
Ah, it's nice meeting you, too.
Oh, boy. Lagaroni.
Woo!
Give your boy the macaroni. Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
Playing people across a big old pond.
Yeah, you know, Japanese release. Everybody's probably in Hong Kong. Don't shoot me. I'm busy. Dropping a nuke. You can't move because the lag's so bad. Uh-oh, is the partner going to get in it?
Oh, jeez.
My fucking partner knocked him out so I didn't get hit by it. It's always their fault, just so you know. Oh, God. Yep. We're on it. Sidestep, step.
Someone quit.
Someone might have quit. I don't blame you.
Seeing some messages pop up there. And? Will we move or will we be dropped?
And?
Will we boot? Yep.
Oh. Aww.
And GPO2 wins!
And we won! There you go, you saw a nuke.
Very impressive.
Somebody wants hot scramble, let's show hot scramble.
Hot scramble. Give me them eggs.
That's the only way I like my meals prepared. Can you scramble any food?
I mean, theoretically.
Think about it. Is there any food you could not scramble?
Define scramble.
Heating it up and turning it into little chunks.
Yes.
Is that what scramble means? Look it up.
You can't scramble soup, though. I'm gonna go ahead and say that soup unscrambled.
That is debatable. That's a debatable claim.
Unless you freeze it. If heated up is not part of the requirement,
yeah.
You could freeze it and then put like a blender on it and then just have like, I guess like a slushy would be a form of scrambling.
That's true.
Next time I ask for a milkshake, I'm just gonna get. Give me a scrambled. Give me a scrambled vanilla ice cream.
I'd like a scrambled vanilla, please. All right, so this
a cup of scrambled vanilla.
Our charge shot is a hot scramble. Is by the way, like everyone thinks he's probably the best suit in the game.
Okay, great. He's DLC.
He's he was like a pre-order thing. He's probably gonna be available later, but you can like curve that.
Pay to win.
A fucking throne over there. Get down. While that suit is up there doing that, she buffs. You know, like the zero system makes it hard for tracks to lock on. She can give that to a friend, basically, okay, while she's charging that.
So she can buff a buddy.
Hot scramble's pretty neat. Turn to a plane right there. Try to use that to get away. Yakushiki is also very good. Oh, got sniped! Good one!
Slap him out of the air!
Oh. Ah, you had it! Why'd you stop me? God, my partner's shooting me! Like, trust me, friend, I have it!
They're showing love in weird ways.
God damn it. Oh, Hotto Scrambaloo!
Oh boy, your enemy hasn't lost a single suit.
I know. Would have killed him, but there we go. Yeah, this Yakushiki's very good. Oh, and they died before me, so I have very low health.
Great!
If you're playing as a 500, your goal is to die first, so you come back with full health, so you don't come back with like a third of it. There's Hot Scramble.
Alright.
I like my Gundam scrambled.
That was pretty hot and scrambled.
A little scrambly.
Hot scrambles in your area.
Yeah.
Vicuno, I believe his tag is, says, what fight stick is Kieran using?
A custom... a WWE Brawl stick that I modded. It's like a cheap-ass stick. You can just put in good parts.
Somebody with a neon green screen name so I can't read it says, I want to see Death Scythe for pure edge.
Edge! My Death Scythe is garbage. Let's do it.
Let's go.
And we're going to pick Blaze Gear, because why not?
Let's go.
Blaze it up. This game has a burst mechanic. That's what the gear things are. When you're in Blaze Gear, like, kind of, I think it triples your stats. Lasts much shorter, but you do more damage. Go nuts. You can also hit all the buttons again. Do your super. There you go. Death Scythe can cloak. Can throw the shield.
That's the needy.
Can go in poncho mode. I'm not playing this game right if I don't use a Mario Kart steering wheel. That's some next level stuff,
dude. That does seem pretty intense. How do you get that connected to a PS4 is my question.
I'm sure there's a way. Bluetooth are all the same.
It's USB. How hard could it be?
Grant, I'm going to have you do the next one. I think you've seen enough.
All right. You think I've learned?
Yeah, I think you've learned.
Okay.
After my pristine showing here.
You have taught me exactly everything I need to know.
I taught you how to play Master. I pretty much taught you how to do your taxes.
Yeah.
That's invaluable knowledge.
You may as well have infinite knowledge.
Good job, friend. Hey, got him with the shield.
Bonk. Oh.
Blaze it. 420 Blaze Gear!
Oh.
Exia is so dumb because Exia can come back as Exia Repair if they were going to lose, but hey, we win.
That's their perk.
Alright! Come on, Grant, show me your skills.
Alright.
Show me what you got. Remember, it's a Japanese game, so circle, which is the bottom.
Is it my thumb? Is it my...
The button that's your thumb next to it.
Whoops.
The blue button, you know, the bottom blue button, it's the white button next to it.
Yeah.
There you go.
Now I figured it out. Oh, I didn't mean to be him again. Oh, well.
Hit op. The start is on the top.
I want a casual match.
I'll show off Jazz Zaku after this.
So,
down. Circle.
Oh, selecting a new mobile suit. Gotcha. Where is my salt friend?
Oh, keep going up. There he is.
And we'll be assisted by... Who would you say is the best?
That we have. Go, keep going up. The Psycho Zaku or Barbatos assist. Actually, go with the Barbatos one. Keep going up. That one, right there. And then do Blaze. Make your punches do a billion damage.
Okay. Let's go. Let's do it.
Remember, A, B, C. C is dash, B is melee. Different directions. Hit A, B, C together to burst. Hit A, B, C again to do your one punch.
Wait, which one's A? Which button is A?
Index finger. So it goes A, B, C. Center row.
The top?
Yep. Okay. Everything labeled blue is A, B, C. And then your other blue button is target change. That's all you need to worry about.
It's weird. I'm used to...
Hit C twice every time you're moving. There you go, you got it. Getting in. And Grant goes in. He's throwing the rock. G. Arcane doesn't know what to do. The rock curves, defying gravity. And we got a kick. The kick connects. It's clean. It's good. An honest suit. The rock in the face. The disrespect. Saved by a teammate.
Ah! What's assists?
The circle. There you go, Barbato saved you. Ah, very good. Get the assist in the rock. Watch out behind you. They're telling you to back off. Do you want to listen to them?
Of course not. Of course not.
I'll pop your gear. Do it. Get right close to him. You got to get very close, then do it. And you'll get one punch. Oh, no!
Trying to get over it. Sorry, Friendo-chan.
Don't listen to them. You're carrying this match. Yeah, the rock!
Oh, jeez. This melee's a little bit slower than I think.
Give him some salt! Oh, target change. One of my birds is locked up. Oh, no!
Now look.
Hey, that was first try.
That was a test.
That's right. Button check.
You threw me in against the... Threw me with sharks.
That's the way you learn.
It's true. It's gonna be okay.
Can you smell what the Zaku is? Get shot. Alright, go for it.
I don't have enough time to practice.
I'm sorry, you're getting games too fast. A gun cannon.
Give me long range support.
Team OG. Ace Jorge with 1,000. This is my first time dropping bits. It was complex as hell figuring out how they work. Well, thank you so much for going through that. We really appreciate it. Nice, good rock. He helps set up for the beam. And remember, you can do, when you do melee, you can dash left or right to cancel. So you can do like BB, dash, dash, BB. Got stunned by the pressure. You can keep it up. Missile's nothing. Missile's cheap.
Gonna throw a rock at him.
Rock him.
Rock him, suck him. Rock him.
Hit an A and B together is your big rock. Yeah! Shook it at him. I love it because fucking you and Gun Cannon both throw rocks. Gun Cannon's ultimate is throwing a giant rock. Nice, Barbatos. Good assist. Ooh, he's so close. Nice! You getting your shit? Yeah!
This is such a dumb suit, but I love
it. It's the best! Oh my god, that is such a risky move! Get, go for the burst, man. You gotta go for the burst. Ah! Yes! It curves so much! It's like, I'm gonna throw it.
That didn't go where I thought it would.
Oh.
No, get no. back on him!
There you go. It's green. There you go. Now you got him.
Luckily, my suit dying doesn't seem to cost that much.
But he, if he dies... Oh, God, go save your friend! Burst! Go nuts! Do it! Oh, no!
All right, that was attempt two.
You got it, man.
As you can see,
you rock it.
Starting to come together already. Look how fast you can pick up this video game.
Did you guys hear about Fooly Cooly? Yes. I'm sure it'll be fine. I'm a little trepidatious.
Yeah. Track record on old thing you like comes back. Not the best.
Do your burst. Just do it. You gotta feel it. Nope. You only get one per thing. You get one attempt. Kind of like, think of it as instant kill.
Yeah.
Said anime, the Hot Scramble is kind of like Build Fighters. I don't know if any more Build Fighter stuff will be in the game. Barbatos, Lupus, and Virtue have been the ones that were announced. Barbatos is right there. Virtue is like
about
in
SD
a few
Gundam?
Days. Dude, if SD Gundam comes in, I'll be so happy. I don't see it happening, but I would love it. I think that was your gun cannon, buddy. Last game.
Now he's getting his revenge.
He's telling you to back off. Fuck off, dude.
Hey, pal,
I got rocks to throw.
I'm not alone.
Oh. That track's so hard.
You can't stop me. Damn it.
These guys know what they're doing. But it's all right. You know what you can't run out of? Rocks. There's no such thing as running out of rocks.
Trying to send my assist, then rock, then punch.
Your assist knocks him down. It does a full combo if it connects. It's a good way to keep them off you if they're coming in. There you go! Yeah! Teamwork!
Sure, let's go with this. Go, my assist.
Oh my god, you have half health. You might just want to run away.
Never! Ah!
You got it! Do you wanna play like the arcade mode thing? Oh, he's yelling at you. Such bad. Next, please. That's exactly what he said. Do you wanna try like the arcade mode?
Sure. So get some, let's just not bring other poor people down.
Yeah. Go and do go up. Do that one. Do trial.
Sure, let's arcade it. Let's
just do easy mode.
Yeah. Just start me off.
There you go. You got your build, you're good.
Okay. Oh, it's a change. And these are the mobile suits.
That looks rad.
That does look really cool. Bum, bum, bum.
Can you bring down the terror that is Zeon?
Of course I can, for I am the Salt Zaku. Me and Amuro are gonna do it right.
These Zaku's using guns? Weak.
You cowards! The earth is my gun!
And you also have different attacks that are AC and BC. You also have two other moves. So you know. That one's like a hug or something? I don't know what it is. Oh, the shark! He's so fast! You're holding up when you do your melee. Don't hit a direction when you're dashing. You don't have to. His forward is a shoulder tackle that pushes them away. There you go. Karate chop!
Take him out!
Chop him in half!
Behold my axe. Truly the greatest instrument of destruction. The very planet itself. Oops. I defend the Earth with Earth.
Good little ball. Isn't it cute?
Get back here, ball.
You also have different attacks for holding, like, back when you're going in. Like, C propels you forward, so you don't have to hold forward. You can, like, hold back, you can hit left. There you go, uppercut! I think you do something out of that, but I can't tell. Ooh! You got dive kick. Ugh!
Please sit back down, sir.
Grant, please have some mercy.
There is no mercy left. Not on this or any planet.
Jeez, I love just the rock. What the fuck, dude?
Hey.
Get him! The pebble!
Go, my friend. Distract him!
Yes!
Bonk! Just took out your window.
The Federation's white devil felled by a rock.
You ain't got the stones to challenge me. I'll salt the very earth you wish to reclaim.
Oh man, you gotta punch a ship.
I mean, I get to punch a ship.
Nice. Follow up. Nice. And whenever you're going and it doesn't work, you can hit left or right twice to do a rainbow step. And that's how you chain melee. So you can do like BB, left, left, right, right, BB. You can do it like just...
Oh boy.
Can you punch that? Go away! Stop!
Stop it!
We don't want you here!
Yeah!
Sir, there's a robot trying to chop us in the back.
I don't know how to respond to this.
Should we do anything?
No, I don't.
Nah, just keep flying in circles. We'll lose them.
I can't believe it. He's chucking his rocks just in the perfect spot.
Oh my god. Sir, a rock is entered. Oh my god, sir, you have to do
you
something.
You don't understand. You have to see this. You're gonna wanna see this. Nope. How's my.
You don't have enough if you're trying to burst. You don't have enough for.
I wanna go in one punch.
Yeah, kill the other Zakus then. If you wanna do that, kill these guys. Get meter. That's what these guys are here for. They'll keep spawning. Hopefully you're.
Don't kill him.
Yeah,
Char, don't. Or Amuro, whoever my friend is in this one.
Ah, man! All these rocks weighing us down.
There's too much mud in the engines. Bring me a real challenge, says Salt Goo.
Kill Sassator with 500. Grant, use rock throw. C's super effective on flying types. That's why. Or was that flying steel?
Yeah, I must have just been flying. Oh, no!
Mirror match.
A mirror!
We need salt for the french fries!
The hell you do!
Nice! I love that you can, because you can like use it kind of as like a shield. It'll eat a projectile when you throw it. Uh-oh. Are there enough rocks for the both of us? Oh god! Save your friend! There you go. Nice! Bam!
Get him from above.
They're very good. So if any, yep, there you go. And you can just keep, like, going step, go step. That's how you do it. You can step cancel any melee.
Slow down for a second.
Oh no!
Hey, you got him! We make a good team, Gun Tanker, whoever you were.
He says, coughing on his own teeth.
Thanks, Gundam. Amuro, you paid your rent with that one.
Alright.
Alright.
End of the road.
Test. The Shao Kahn of Gundams.
Okay. I wouldn't go that far.
Goro, maybe?
Maybe Goro. We've been bred for military combat. We were raised in the space military program. We're getting destroyed by a guy throwing rocks.
I can't.
We weren't trained what to do to a rock.
Say if you love something, put a rock on it. Ow.
Good. Get away from the disco.
Oh, come on.
Step. Oh. Good dodge.
God.
You know what you have to do. Do it!
No!
Oh, no! You're mashing it. You gotta position it.
I tried to punch once and then get it.
Oh my god, he's so close. Can you do it without dying? You have to do this.
Where were you, support?
Do it! Yes!
I threw a rock. It was a big rock.
I did it.
Behold me and my salty fury.
Good shit.
All right, this character is definitely
dumb and goofy.
He's not quite goofy.
He's not goofy. Oh, dude, shit, really quick. Did you have anything else you wanted to do? Because I'm like...
What I wanted to do would probably take a little bit more time than we have really left.
Okay.
7:30.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
I was going to mess with a SNES game, but it's a JRPG and has a bit of a lead-in.
Okay.
So I can bust it out another week.
I'm going to unlock some shit.
Go for it.
You got a...
What did we get?
Got Gundam support. We got... Oh, Zaku 1. I assume that says Rock Master.
And a title.
Maybe Rock Apprentice.
The Rock Man.
Oh, Jazz.
Ah, we haven't shown Jazz.
I have not shown off Jazz. So this is my main suit.
Is this who you play
ridiculous
on your own
thing.
Time, on your own file, back
yeah,
at home?
Yeah, when I play this video game, I play this.
So, I think you might have explained it earlier, but the difference between Blaze and Lightning, what...
Blaze triples your stats, Lightning reduces your boost, and also Blaze refills your ammo and your partner's ammo.
Okay.
Lightning refills your boost and your partner's boost, and it also makes your boost cost, like, I think a third of what it is. So you might not go, like, super fast, but you can boost more, so you can stay in the air longer. And it makes you a bit more mobile.
Okay.
It has one other really good thing. It also lasts longer. It has one other boon, but I can't remember what it is. So, you know, this guy's from Gundam Thunderbolt. Really good show. And, you know, all the Gundam music's pretty good. I like my Gundam music.
Yes, Gundam music. Pretty good.
I mean, for the most part.
People asking if this Gundam throws rocks also.
No, do you see how many...
I think those guns.
Do you see these guns?
I'll tell you the answer.
That would be great if he threw rocks with all these guns, though.
With all of those guns. Like, just as he's shooting off everything on his shoulders, he's just throwing rocks.
Yeah, just
rocks.
Chucks one little rock.
I can't wait for you to get matched up with one of the people I was with. And they're like, oh, and here's this shitty
here's
guy.
This asshole. So here's the theme to Gundam Thunderbolt. I'm not going to say a damn word.
Now see, I'm alright with this part. Then it gets into it. Like that's... I'm not into that. And I was in a jazz band. I get that this is jazz, but this is the unfun jazz.
What's wrong with this?
It's dissonant is what it is.
Maybe you just have a bad taste in music.
Nah. Like, I get the jazz is supposed to be, like, free-flowy and fun, but this feels like they're just following no rule or order and just kind of all yelling at a microphone.
You like jazz? Do you like jazz, though? Do you like the genre of music?
Alright, I need this song coupled with the B-movie, B says jazz a billion times. It keeps
echoing? Okay.
More. Seems the chat agrees. While this may be jazz, it is bad jazz.
It's pretty bad.
Yes, Cowboy Bebop vomited on Gundam. Thank you, Gola from Biloa.
Don't you love it?
Lightning!
Did I get my super off? I think I did. Yes! Oh, and it stopped him. Hell yeah. All right, I got like no health. It's up to you to save us, buddy. Oh, man, they know I'm low. Ah, fucking damn it. Oh, well. GG. So, yeah, that was jazz. I was playing during the demo. I was like, oh, I like Psycho Zaku. And everybody was like, Kieran, I hate you. Stop playing this. Like, my suit, I'm sorry. I love this suit. I'm sorry about the music. what you can do, though, which is pretty neat. You can change the background music per suit.
Ah, good.
So, hey, this song, we never have to hear this ever again. We're just going to put on good songs. Like The Winner and I Senshi. And that one Gundam Seed song, that's real good.
No jazz boys up in here. Nothing doing.
Windmill Gundam is Gundam, correct.
Yes. Okay, I saw some people asking about Tequila Gundam and a couple other G Gundams. If you missed the discussion on it earlier, they're coming later. Like, I don't know which ones, but I'm assuming, like, the main gang, and
my uncle's a Gundam. He told me it's coming. Don't worry about it. Yes, it's the Premium Sound Edition. I'll do one more with Mr. Zaku here.
Go for it.
Oh, my God.
Will you do one more? Oh, okay, now it's exactly. Now you're moving.
I'll try my damnedest.
Lag switches.
Everybody knows all the Chinese players have lag switches. I gotta hit this Exia. I can't wait for this to come out in America so I can actually play with people that are in America! But if this looks like your jam, if you like Gundam, I will be like trying to arrange events for people that have it. I have a whole bunch of friends that play this game and stuff.
Well, and I know you've been streaming it like every night since this came out.
Oh yeah, I do. I do stream it every night. Can I plug that? Am I allowed, Dad?
No, but I'm saying it for you, so twitch.tv/LordMoonstone.
Yeah.
Okay. It's good to remember you still use that.
I do still use that handle, okay. Unfortunately.
Where you play lots of Goondams.
I do.
And I'm sure once it comes out in the U.S., you'll be setting up playdates and all kinds of stuff.
We will be setting up playdates.
And this will be a PS4. Seemingly exclusive.
Oh my god.
I felt really bad though, because this game like looks cool and it's clearly fun. At Anime Expo they had a booth for like this Ni No Kuni or Ni No Kuni, whatever the new one is. Some Witch Academia or something.
Oh, like, yeah, that game. Sure.
And something else, and then Dragon Ball FighterZ, and the only one I saw like a line at was FighterZ.
I'm sure.
I'm everybody swarmed that one.
Duh. It's just like the biggest show stealer of E3. I'm not surprised at all. Weep not for Gundam. It will always have its fans.
It's just one of those things where I know this is a good game, but everyone, I'm sure, just looked at it and went, well, that's weird. Let's play the fighting game.
I was so bad. I'm not a synth. My uncle's a Gundam, not me. Yeah, Ni No Kuni's getting it's a sequel, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
Ni No Tuni?
Yeah, Ni No Tuni. I feel like, and this is funny because I think Ni No Kuni originally came out on the 3DS or the DS.
DS.
I can't remember what timing it was. And then it was eventually moved to the PS3, And that came out here. The DS one never came out here.
Yeah.
I played the PS3 one and thought, man, I would probably really like this if I could take it on the go. This is not a game I feel like playing on a TV, despite how beautiful it is.
Yep. That's me with every RPG.
And now Ni No Kuni's coming out, and I feel that same way, where I'm just like, I want to take this with me.
I saw somebody said a suit. That's what I was waiting for. Let's do Shenlong. Ultron.
All right. Gaming Impulse calling out your showstopper of E3. Nintendo says, hold my beer. The more I think about it, the less I like Nintendo's press conference. Because Nintendo's thing has always been, here's this game you didn't know existed, and it's coming out soon.
Mm-hmm.
Their press conference this time was all like either stuff I knew about or stuff that was way distant.
Yeah, 2018, I think, like
and
everything.
That's a huge bummer, because that's like, I know everybody does that, so it didn't seem like this thing.
Yeah.
But Nintendo never does that. And the fact that they did is actually a big step backwards for me. Like, Odyssey's coming, and that looks cool. Like, I totally think that'll be fun.
That was it.
But, like, that's, like, kind of it for what's really coming.
Yeah, for this year at least. Should you get a Switch or a PS4? If you don't have a PC, get a PS4. Then get a Switch.
And as cool as the idea of New Prime, a logo is not enough to sell me.
No, because, you know, isn't it a different team?
It's... The Metroid thing that's on the 3DS is the really bad Castlevania team.
That's scary.
That could go bad places. Prime, I don't remember if they've said anything on the team, but I don't think it's the same team. And like, yeah, I'm not saying I think that the stuff they showed was bad. It's just that The time frame, and it was all kind of like all the stuff that is coming soon was known quantities, and all the stuff that's far away were very vague and just like, here's a title, or here's a yes, we're making this, and that's not enough for me.
Man, this GM Custom just stomped my partner, and I gotta get this full armor though.
Check out my long arms.
Shit! Hey, nice.
Also, I really hated the character designs for that new Xenoblade game. Like,
everyone has been shitting on them, and I agree. Good one, partner. I'm not even mad about it.
It worked.
Man, that GM Custom just stomped my partner. Wow.
He just came in and wrecked you guys.
I just love how movement works in this game. Like, this is a game about positioning.
It seems very interesting. I'm just bad at figuring out the movement.
Once you learn the movement fundamentals.
It seems like a very rhythm thing. Like, just knowing the timing when moving will work, and stepping right in, not immediately intuitive, but seeing you do it is like, okay, I can see where this can eventually go.
Any plans for the weekend, Grant?
Well, this evening, one of my favorite podcasts always does their thing live on Friday night, and tonight is their 500th episode.
Giant Bomb?
Jim and them.
Oh, cool.
And they're doing a big thing for it, so that's probably what I'll be doing immediately after the stream.
Yo, nice.
For the weekend, though, I don't know. I'd like to see Spider-Man, but I, you know, don't want to go by myself and... Don't know if anyone else that around us is planning to go.
Yeah.
I know Lanny had asked the other day, but now he's not feeling well, and no one really has solid plans at the moment, so might be something that I'll end up seeing next week. But other than that, continuing my 100% run on Vesperia.
How's that going?
Trying to do that. I've gotten to the third act of this long-ass three-act game, about 40-some hours in.
Wow.
But already missed a bunch of stuff, so this is not going to be the end of the 100% attempt. Going to have to jump into New Game Plus and do it again. But that should hopefully expedite a lot of stuff. Someone again with a neon green name, so I can't quite read it. Do you think do you guys think the Switch will be good in the future, or do you just hate it? I actually just bought a Switch.
I love it.
I already think it's good. I don't think it's a in the future thing.
The Switch is fantastic.
I think it's there.
Yeah. Like, I love the Switch.
Some of the popular headlining games are not really my cup of tea.
Yeah.
Like ARMS didn't really do it all that much for me.
It's
Splatoon. Yeah. I think is a neat game, but it's not something that I would like call myself excited about. It's just one of those things where it's like, yeah, I'll probably eventually get it, pick it up,
yeah,
play it for a while with some friends, and kind of that'll be that. But no, I already think the Switch is a solid console.
It's really, really good. I want more long-form RPGs. That's why even if the Xenoblade game has stupid character designs, if it plays great, I don't care.
I will probably give it a shot. Because I do love me colorful JRPGs, and that looks like a colorful-ass JRPG.
Citizen Lawyer with 500. Any interest in getting free copies of the GBA Fire Emblem game sent to the P.O. Box? Doesn't have to be for streamer series. Private use is cool, too.
I mean, sure.
That'd be cool, sure.
Definitely wouldn't be against them if you're offering to send them. We do have means to play them, and nothing says we can't.
Yeah, no, I'd like to.
Something with them.
And I'm trying to go through more of the stuff we have, like when time permits.
Yeah.
Like, Ben and I recorded a one shot, which unfortunately probably won't happen, and I'm really sad about that because it was hysterical.
Yeah, you sounded pretty excited about
it. I was really excited for it. But who knows, we did our thing of the mask, we just walked over to our shelf, and I was like, just play the mask.
Sure.
Mask the. Jokage with 13, Jokage 13 with 600, who do you guys think is the most broken anime character? I don't know if we're...
I'll have to think for a sec. I mean, did you say there's some upcoming JoJo's characters who are insane?
Yeah, there are upcoming JoJo's characters that are nuts. I don't like getting into power debates. I absolutely hate it, so I couldn't tell you who I'm like, oh, this guy's the best ever. Because I'm sure there's some visual novel that has my powers to warp existence. I have the reality stone. I'm the best. So
I'm going to try and think of just the characters that I know and can document mentally. Who I think was the strongest.
Damn it. That's the gun tank assist. That's really good. Or if that was just regular ass gun tank. This is bad. I'm front now. Togi says really weird movement. You see how he like moves like that? Like he kind of like flips. It's really weird.
I feel like if he wasn't such an idiot, Okuyasu from the JoJo's would be one of the strongest characters in anime existence.
Dude, right?
But I think that's kind of the fun of JoJo's is they give incredible powers to some characters who are too stupid to use them properly.
Yeah.
Also, Rohan, he can just get into your brain manga and write, "You can't beat me," and now you've lost it.
Yeah.
I mean, sure, you have to look at his comic book first, so obviously there are ways around that, but he could set that up to make it impossible to avoid. He could line the walls with it.
Shit.
Anta ga neri dakke dou datte ni. Anta ga teki datte koto ni kawari wa nai nda.
They're hunting that V, which is good, because if I can just snipe this dude... Thank God my partner's amazing. There we go! Awesome! That snipe assist, hell yeah! Broken anime character, I don't know. The Death Note's a pretty good power.
Yeah, that's alright, but he's gotta know your name.
That's true.
Couldn't win a battle of anonymity.
Yeah. I had a mod planned. I had a Counter-Strike mod planned about Death Note.
Ooh.
We're gonna call it Kerenzo from Cleanse the World.
Wow, not much happened this turn.
Nice.
You haven't done any sounds yet. I'm sad.
It's one of those things where, like, I feel like the soundboard's majesty is in being seldom used. So when it comes out, like, you really appreciate it.
I agree.
If it's just, oh man, every event that could even slightly be related.
Submit! Blarg!
Like, it's just...
It loses its impact.
Yeah,
it's not a joke. It's now a. Now you're a clown.
It's one of those, like, use it like not enough. You're down here, using it like just enough brings you up here.
Felker.
But then you use it too much and it drops significantly.
Yeah.
Like, I would rather not use it at all than too much.
Yeah, it's a Belker. Absolutely.
That's an ugly ass color.
Kyakushiki?
Yeah.
Oh, you're wrong. In this lighting, it looks really weird, but he's gold.
Oh, okay. Yeah, from here, it looks like puke green.
Yeah, he looks like puke green. Oh, that's an Epion. Hello. Oh, God, that was a rock.
I wonder what he's going to do.
Hey, what's this?
Check out my gun.
I ran out of boost, so I couldn't cancel it like you're supposed to. What's that garbage combo? Get good, son. Let me show you melee. I'm going to show you how to melee, dude. It's stuffed.
Are you shooting behind?
Yeah, he has a back shot.
That's great. I like that a lot.
Do you know who pilots the Kyakushiki?
I do not.
Quattro Bagina.
Oh, hey.
One Char Aznable.
One secret Char.
Nice. I've got an X2 partner, that's why. X2's so good. See Epion. I'll buy. I love when it turns into a clusterfuck in a corner. Yeah, the back shot is great. I got you, friend! Get off me. I will save you from the wrath that is Epion. Get up so I can do my ultimate! Oh. So you can set the hyper cannon and cancel it.
There you go. Get him out of there.
Takashiki's great.
And I've got my cool floating platform.
Yeah, he does. Gotta sell toys. Code Taka with 1,000 says, you mentioned Death Note, but you're assuming the only eligible character is Light. What about Ryuk? Can't take damage, can see your name, and also has a Death Note. That's true. If you could prompt Ryuk to do it, then yes.
Just give him lots of apples.
Somebody wanted funnels.
Let's funnel it up.
Let's have some fun.
Let's have some fun. Funnel cake! Funnel cake reminds me of dessert, and dessert reminds me... Another thing I'll probably do this weekend is pick up some Cocoa Krispies and put it
on ice cream?
Ice cream, because that's incredible.
Yeah, that sounds really good.
Apparently, like, when I said that on Twitter, people were like, you've never heard of that? Like,
I hadn't heard of that.
That's a thing. And I'm like, I have never heard of that, and I feel like I have gone to quite a few ice creameries and never seen it offered.
Yeah. You're quite the creamist.
Yeah. And, like, one of the other things at this place was, like, Captain Crunch. And I've seen that before, and I'm sure that's fine, too. But Cocoa Krispies seems A++, top tier. So which Gundam is this one from?
This is from the novelization interpretation of Char's Counterattack. This is a different...
So you never get to see this one animated?
You never see this one animated.
Wow.
Oh, this is garbage. But here go funnels! Go get them! I can't shoot, but my funnels can.
I'm digging this music.
Yeah, it's a good theme from Char's Counterattack. See, this is good for practice. It's nice to slow down time. See just how deliberate your moves are.
Excaliburner, Grant, if you could choose between flying at 20 miles an hour or running at 80 miles an hour, which would you choose? Flying.
Yeah, I absolutely.
Because, hey, at that speed, I'd have to, like, wear goggles to run properly.
But you'd look cool with goggles.
And also, flight is just more fun.
Flight is absolutely more fun.
Like, even if it's a quarter of the speed. 20 miles an hour is fast enough. You do that.
That'll get you to CVS and back without having to drive.
Well, that and, like, you do that with just your body, like, without something surrounding you, it's gonna feel fast. Yeah, maybe not compared to running 80 miles an hour, but if I never experience that...
True.
The 20 is gonna feel plenty quick.
The Chinese connection up in here. New type powers! I'm a new type. I love that they tweet this out, by the way. They're like, check out our thing for Gundam Versus. Or do they say, hey, new types, check out our thing for Gundam Versus. And they show off Wing Zero with hashtag Wing Zero. Like, what idiot did that?
No, let's get hashtag Wing Zero trending.
Hashtag Wing Zero. Hey, new types.
Yo, new types.
Just kidding. I don't know if the fucking PR rep for Bandai Namco's Twitter watches this. I love you. I'm sure you're great.
If someone from Bandai Namco's Twitter watches this, why haven't you responded to my continued begging for Tales of Phantasia to come to the PlayStation eShop?
It's not?
No. All of the old Tales games are like $100+ to find them physical without the case, and they're not putting any of them on the shop, ever.
Wow. That's
I'm not
stupid.
Even begging for the ones that never got a translation. You know what? Fine. I'd love to play Eternia, but if you really don't want me to, fine. But you put Destiny out, Phantasia got a PSP release or something, I'm pretty sure. Like, just give it to me!
I think I'm gonna win.
Oh yeah, Phantasia got the GBA one. That's the one that came out in English. But like, there's a translation out there. It exists.
Yeah. Can I like...
Can you quit this
match?
Yeah,
that's what I can do this.
You know what? I'm not even going to beg for PS3 Vesperia, even though that is clearly the superior version, because I'm sure, like, Microsoft got it all tied up in, you know, exclusivity in the West or something. So, you know what? Fine. That's probably a fight you can't win. I get it. But there's no reason not to put those old ones out. I feel like...
Yeah, right.
It's not like they're very big, so it's not like you're wasting server space on them. Like,
yeah.
They're the size of, like, a costume in the new games.
All right, Grant. Do you want to round us out?
All right. One last game?
Yeah.
One last battle for them all.
You played easy mode on arcade. I think you've done all the training you need.
I believe you. I've learned.
There you go.
I think you're ready.
My time is now. I'm so confident. 1v1. No. That does not seem like the way to play this.
Oh,
I don't know what you do with that. It might be a block. Maybe you can, like, just, that's your get in, maybe. Maybe it negates projectiles. I don't know.
Maybe it's just position. Like, maybe it's just a get in real quick.
Maybe.
Because
maybe you want to do BB, step, BB. Hopefully you don't have horrible lag.
Here I am. Rock you, because that's what I do.
Are you a rock romancer?
I am.
Meatloaf was a rock romancer.
Whoa, this looks good.
What is happening with these potato connections?
This looks good.
It might. If it doesn't drop, we can say fuck it.
Three.
Two.
Agent Sheffield is here to stop the funky ghost.
Hey, save us. While you get matches fast and casual, I wish you could set a don't match me with potato connections. Or, because in player match you can choose worldwide or region. I wish you could do that for casual. BB, right, BB. Try that. There you go. That's how you cambo.
Gotcha. Someone on their side is probably going like, ugh, can't believe another American's playing with us.
Right.
Just slowing us down. Probably bad at the game.
Probably just got the game. Never heard of it. Got the Japanese release.
I don't know what a Gundam is, but they
got the Japanese release.
Friggin' Hello Kitty, so they think they know Japanese art.
You can do it. Ooh, good dunk. Yo, you're with Star _ Platinum TW.
I feel like I just don't know where to support. Get in there, please.
Boom! You can do it. It's just Gundam X, yeah? He can't do anything to you. Ah! Very good.
Feel that one.
Yep,
working.
You. Oh, nice! Double shot killed them both. I should just go in and. Probably gonna die. There you go. That's fine, you come back full health! If you actually want to actually win, you can hang back. Throw some rocks. This guy will style on you. They seem pretty competent.
Where's my friend?
To your right. Good! Oh, don't! No! You're scaring the balls out of me, Grant.
I was like, I'll rock him! It'll be fine!
They read you!
Everything's gonna be okay.
They read you like a fiddle!
I'm lining up a rock. It's gonna be perfectly okay. Oh, well.
Can't rock them all.
Shucks.
Heck. Fudge. I want to do one last thing.
Okay.
One last thing.
Somebody type my neon green friend's name so I can see it, because the green is too bright for these monitors. Light green on white, not visible. But he is begging me to have a closer look at his name.
Yeah.
Red Reaper 66. Red Reaper 66. That's the guy who has asked multiple questions that I've brought up.
Answered. Your best friend?
Yeah. Okay. Seems like a good dude. He loves a neon green. Who doesn't? But on a white background, it's real tough to see from like 5 feet away.
Yeah, I imagine.
Oh boy. All swords all day.
All day. Only the best. Let's see what happens.
Who has the biggest sword?
Alright, let's go! Let's go! Oh god! Oh god!
Nani!
Okay, he's got a whip. Yes! Hey, get off him! Hey, that looks really cool.
Seeing that from the side looks really cool. So one thing I'm noticing from this game that does kind of bum me out is, are there no alt colors?
I don't think so.
Whoop-bam!
Oh, come on. I want to get him with the dunk! With the dunk!
Win!
Great!
You were FBI.
Perfect.
Fire with that one.
This has been Gundam Versus. I stream this game and other shit over on twitch.tv/LordMoonstone. I might be doing stuff tonight. My boy Grant doesn't stream, but he should. Bother him.
Versus.
On Twitter at MasterWuggles. Anything else?
Nah, I got nothing.
All right.
Can't think of anything. Thanks for watching.
This has been Casual Friday. Y'all stay beautiful.
We can go
away.
Bye.
For the weekend.
See you on Tuesday for whatever we decide to end up doing.
We'll have something. Stay tuned on Monday for a stream that we never do.
What? Never.
Never. See you guys.